know that today we're going to give credit to Chad, who was dogged in his effort to make sure he wasn't stopped in this investigation, no matter how many people tried to stop him. But we know that it's also, it's a community of law enforcement that stand together, work together to make sure these cases come to fruition. And at a time in our society where law enforcement is not always thanked, sometimes in some communities, law enforcement is demonized. I think it's always important to stand behind and with the men and women who every day in our community stand with us, trying to protect us and make our community safer. We just got back from an event in Warsaw, talking about opioids and meth and heroin and how this is ravaging our communities. What's happening with those who are addicted and how we treat them. But the other side is, how do we deal with the supply that's coming into our communities? Who's at the forefront of that fight, keeping these drugs out? And it's our law enforcement that is at the forefront of that fight. And if they can't do their job, our communities are not safe. We have a continual flow of these drugs that, again, devastate communities. They crush the individual. And I know those in law enforcement see this all too often, but what does it do to little kids who are living in homes where these horrible drugs are being used? And if you don't mind, I'm going to give you a copy of that, Sheriff, when we're done. But let me just read that for you all. So it's not just here in Lincoln County, it's not just here in Merrill, but we want to make sure that our country understands that we are part of this greater fight to keep our communities safe and our communities drug-free. In our congressional record, my statement. Mr. Speaker, I'd like to recognize the dedication and bravery of our nation's law enforcement, especially in relation to keeping drugs out of our communities. I'd like to commend the efforts of Wisconsin officers who are on the front lines to halt the flow of methamphetamines into our communities. After a three-year investigation, that's dedication. After a three-year investigation conducted by local, state, and federal law enforcement agencies, nine individuals have pled guilty to conspiring to distribute meth in central Wisconsin. During that period, the individuals involved distributed 127 pounds of meth at a value of $5.7 million. These heroes in law enforcement deserve our praise. They go to work every day not knowing if they are coming home that night. And they are leading the fight against meth, which has scourged our families and our communities. Meth distributors intentionally seek to create new addicts in our communities by flooding the market with cheap product and targeting individuals. Our officers see the consequences of meth in the eyes of the children they rescue from homes consumed by this addiction. That's why the fight against this epidemic is so important and why we are eternally grateful for their service. I'd like to recognize the Lincoln County Sheriff's Office, especially Detective Lieutenant Chad Collinsworth, the Wisconsin Department of Justice, Division of Criminal Investigation, the Wausau Office of the FBI, the Drug Enforcement Administration, the Marathon County Sheriff's Office Special Investigative Unit, the Wausau Police Department, and the IRS Criminal Investigative Unit for all of their work on behalf of our community. Mr. Speaker, I encourage all Americans to take the opportunity to thank a police officer in their community. They have our backs, and the least that we can do is let them know that we have theirs.
Recognize Chad. I want to read a recognition award that we gave to Chad previously, and it's the Sheriff's Recognition Award. To Lieutenant Chad Collinsworth, he played an integral part in the investigation of the largest drug conspiracy case in the history of Lincoln County and the Western District of Wisconsin. Lieutenant Collinsworth devoted almost 3 years to this investigation. The conclusion of this resulted in the indictment, conviction, and sentencing of 19 defendants who are facing a total of 158 years in federal prison. A total of 127 pounds of methamphetamine has been confiscated with a street value of $5.7 million. Lieutenant Collinsworth further sacrificed his time at the expense of his personal life, as the time needed to bring this case to conclusion took a considerable amount away from his family and social life. Lieutenant Collinsworth's dedication to duty and consistent exceptional job performance reflects great credit upon himself and the Lincoln County Sheriff's Office.
You, and it's such an honor to get this. I can only really accept it as part of the team. Special Agent Jeremy Boss from Wisconsin Department of Justice, Special Agent Steve Whitecotton from FBI. We had the support of course, the Sheriff, Sheriff Yeager. We also had the support and guidance of the U.S. Attorney's Office in Madison. Assistant U.S. Attorney Dan Graber was critical in getting this through. Acting U.S. Attorney Jeff Anderson played a big role in getting this through. While I'm here, and I thank you for this great, great honor, and I thank everyone for coming out here, this is something I truly share with my partners. We all did this together as a team. This isn't anything that I did by myself. So I thank you very much for this.
The title of Chief Deputy, I'm proud about that. But I'm also proud of the fact that I'm a 20-year retiree from the Lincoln County Sheriff's Department. And today is a great day, and thank you for that. This is... Sheriff knows that I was involved in the drugs when we first got into it many years ago, and we had a metro drug unit at Oneida, Lincoln, Langlade, and we worked hard at that. I know the hours that you took away, and that's the thing that people don't realize. And I'm going to say something that includes all of these guys in brown, which I'm very proud of, and I guess I still wear. They leave for third shift, let's just use that as an example. And they've hugged their spouse, and they ruffled the hair of their kids, and they pet the dog, and they go out that door not knowing what's ahead of them. Every night they do that. And I think Lincoln County, I'm proud of Lincoln County because the people of Lincoln County, the citizens of Lincoln County, have a lot of respect for our local law enforcement, and I can only be proud of that. But the thing that was said, and I know what Chad's effort is, you miss the holidays with your family, you miss the birthdays, you miss the school and family outings and that. But when you're dedicated, when we have dedicated young officers like that, we're headed in the right direction in Lincoln County. I know the sheriff pretty well, and I'm gonna tell you that his selections lately and throughout his career here have been great. And I was fortunate to have some awful good officers, one or two still hanging around, I think, but maybe not yet, but they're close. But I really appreciate what you've done. I'm extremely proud of this honor that you should absolutely receive for your efforts and stuff. And we don't know how many people this is really going to impact. And I applaud you for that, and I'll do it right now. Thank you very much.
Chad and the Sheriff's Department has been very instrumental in helping us at the city. We know it's a county-wide problem, not just out in the woods. Chad has been able to take the time away from his duties and his prosecutions. He's been out to the sports club for a couple evenings to educate the hunters and the sportsmen on what to be aware of, what to look for, and what to look out for when they're out of the field, because as you all know, the cartels are up in our force, up in this part of the state. It's an ongoing problem. He was also instrumental in coming over to the city last year and a committee of the whole meeting convincing my council of the need for a full-time drug interdiction officer. It's taking us a little while to get that going, but yeah, we're going to have to tell it back on full-time again. So Chad, thank you for that. And I guess I can also thank him. He spent a lot of time away from his family, but he still had the time to turn out one hell of a football player for the city. So. And you could be proud of that. That's a son anybody would be proud of, so we thank you for that. Jack, congratulations. Thanks for all you've done for the county and for our community.